Good morning, dear students. In this session, let us learn or discuss another poem by D.H. Lawrence titled Butterfly. In this poem, let us try to understand the journey of the butterfly from snow-capped hill to the strong sea. The butterfly moves from the hillside to the sea. Let us try to understand the journey of that butterfly. Besides that, let us try to understand the metaphorical meanings, including the autobiographical meaning. The journey of the butterfly is not just the journey of the butterfly. The journey has so many metaphorical meanings. And it has also an autobiographical meaning. Let us study those meanings, those levels of meaning in the poem. Besides that, let us try to identify the warm and turbulent images used in the poem. So in this poem, after studying this poem, we learn the hurdles one faces in life. We face so many hurdles in our day-to-day life. Snow-laden wind, storm sea, these are some of the hurdles the butterfly faces on its way. We also learn that life keeps moving and even love cannot withhold one at a particular place. In this poem, we learn that life keeps moving. It is not stagnant. It keeps moving. Even love cannot withhold anyone or any particular living being at one particular place. Even love cannot hold it. So let us try to appreciate the daredevil nature of the butterfly in the poem. The poem is about the journey of the butterfly from the snow-capped hills to the stormy sea through the garden. Most probably the butterfly starts its journey from the snow-capped hills. And it wants to reach the stormy sea. The sea is not calm. It is very, very turbulent, stormy. From the hill cap, snow-capped hills to the stormy sea, it has to pass through the land. It comes across a garden on the way. The setting of the speaker's garden where he addresses the butterfly. The setting of the poem is the speaker's garden. The speaker is there in his garden. The butterfly comes to the garden on its way to the sea. Then the speaker or the owner of the garden addresses the butterfly. The butterfly is lost in the wind. It is aimless and possibly searching the way. Butterfly might have lost its way because of the turbulent wind, and it seems aimless now, and it is possibly searching for the right way. So the speaker, when he saw the butterfly, appeals to the butterfly. The butterfly is sitting on his shoe instead of on the flower, as they generally do. Butterflies generally sit on the flowers and leaves or plants. But this particular butterfly sits on the shoe of the speaker or the gardener. The shoe stands for the heart. It is a metaphor for heart of the gardener. The outside weather is very, very stormy. The weather outside the garden is very, very stormy. That is why the butterfly lost its way and it felt disturbed. The garden is very, very warm with red geraniums. It is a kind of flower that we find in the garden. The garden is very, very warm, unlike the weather outside the garden. So the poet appeals, requests the butterfly to stay with him in his garden. he appeals to the butterfly not to go away or go out of his garden, because his garden is very, very comfortable. It is very, very warm. But the outside weather is very, very stormy, very, very turbulent. And it is very harmful to the delicate butterfly. So he requested or he appealed the butterfly to stay back in his garden. His appeal seems to be, he seems to be lonely and he wanted company. That is why the speaker requested the butterfly to stay back, to give him company. And he badly needed company since he was all alone in the garden. The garden is like a parental home and is like an island of serenity in the troubled world. So the garden is just like a parental home, very, very comfortable home for any human being or creature. It is just like its own home. And it is just like an island in the stormy environment. It is just like an island of serenity, calmness in the troubled world. All around there is a troubled world. Hard wind is blowing, severe wind is blowing outside. But the garden is very, very comfortable. It is just like an island of serenity, calmness. That is why this butterfly landed in the garden. And the gardener or the owner of the garden, who is the speaker, appeals to the butterfly to stay back with him and give him company. He shows the tender feelings to the butterfly. The speaker speaks in a very, very tender tone, a very, very mild tone. He describes butterfly in his address. He addresses the butterfly. He calls it butterfly. You see the words that he uses to describe or address the butterfly. First he calls it butterfly. Then he calls it white butterfly. Next he says big soft wings, black dotted butterfly, and he calls it white speck. So the poet uses different terms to describe butterfly in the poem. The word warm repeated constantly in the poem. The poet uses the word warm so many times to appeal to the butterfly to stay back with him, not to go away in the wild wind. The sea is very stormy. The snow-capped hill is very, very cold outside. That is why he requests, appeals to the butterfly and says that his garden is very, very comfortable, very, very warm, very cozy. These words show the tender feelings of the speaker to the butterfly. The wind that blows strong beyond the garden wall. The wind blows very, very strong beyond the garden wall. It is raging. It is contrasted with the peaceful and calm home environment. The garden is the home. There is home environment in the garden. Outside the garden, there is raging wind, turbulence, disturbance. So the poet shows the tender feelings to the butterfly. Then he persuades for the stay of the butterfly in the garden. He puts forth his own arguments before the butterfly to stay back in his garden. He says, October, this is the month of October. This is the month of winter. Of bitter cold has set in already. You see, butterfly, this is the winter season, October. The bitter cold has set in already. We have to go too far away to reach the sea. You have to face the bitter wind, bitter cold on the way. You cannot tolerate the bitter cold. That's why, stay back. This is the first argument the speaker puts forth before the butterfly. Then he says, wind blows seaward. Strong wind blows. Oh, butterfly, you see, wind blows towards the sea. The wind is very, very strong. It will hurt you. You cannot tolerate the strong wind. You may collapse and die. Don't venture into the stormy wind. Stay back in the cozy, comfortable garden and be with me. Enjoy my company. The wind from the hilltop is heavy with snow. Even the wind that blows from the hilltop is heavy with snow due to cold. The soft wings are not strong enough to withstand the force of the stormy wind. You are a soft creature. Your wings are still softer. They are not strong enough to withstand the force of the stormy wind. Can you tolerate the stormy wind and survive? No, you cannot. So, he persuades the butterfly to stay back in his garden. Its attempt to venture out is like attempting an impossible task, like reaching the invisible rainbow. He says to the butterfly, "You are trying to venture out like an your attempt to venture out is like attempting an impossible task. Being a small creature, you are trying to attempt an impossible task. Even men or strong animals or creatures are not able to achieve or venture out in such an environment. But you are trying to venture out into the strong wind. Your attempt is just like reaching the invisible rainbow. Even the rainbow is not visible. Even though the rainbow is visible, it is somewhere in the sky. It is too far away from us. But you are trying to reach the rainbow. It is highly impossible. Don't make such an attempt to reach some impossible things. Don't achieve the impossible tasks or things. Instead of doing all such things, be with me and be comfortable. That way, the speaker persuades the butterfly to stay back in his garden. So the poet uses certain imageries of warmth and stormy. These are the quite opposite imageries. Certain images show the warmth and some images show the stormy wind. October, the word or the month, indicates the arrival of winter season. Winter is a season of death, which shows death. Stormy weather is shown in the month of October. The wind blowing seaward and strong beyond the compound walls indicates the dangers ahead. The wind is blowing strongly seaward towards the sea. It is blowing beyond the compound walls of the garden. So it very clearly indicates that the garden is very, very comfortable and safe. The outside environment is very, very stormy, very, very strong. An ordinary creature cannot withstand the dangers that are there in store for it. The hilltop covered with the snow is also very, very unpleasant. It is only the garden, the flower, stand for warmness in the poem. Only the garden is very, very safe place. Even the hill, even the sea, and the outside area is also very stormy and cold. It is not very, very comfortable for the small creature like butterfly. Even after the request or appeal, the butterfly departs from the garden. The repeated request to stay back with him did not yield any expected results. He appealed with innumerable arguments, but these arguments did not fall on the ears of the butterfly. It went away from the garden. When he left the garden, he wishes the butterfly. He says, "Farewell, farewell, lost soul." You see the word lost soul. You are dead. You are not going to survive in the outside world. It is very, very dangerous. You have melted in the crystalline distance. You called melted. You will not survive. It is enough. I saw you vanish into the air. It is enough. He feels satisfied that he was able to see her at last. I saw you vanish into the air. It vanishes into the air. Immediately it disappears. He cannot see it any longer. It means to say that he bid farewell to the butterfly once for all. He can no longer see it, and it can no longer survive in the outside stormy environment. So, the butterfly disappeared in the air and it lost. He wished it farewell. The speaker wished it farewell. The ending of the poem is often not used. This ending, these lines, farewell, farewell, lost soul, these lines are not often used in many versions of the poem. But the poet wrote these lines also and included in the poem. But in some versions, these lines are missing. Now let us look into the metaphorical meanings as we mentioned in the introductory slide. Here, butterfly can be a person with whom the speaker is in love with. Butterfly is not just a butterfly. It is a metaphorical. Butterfly can be any person or a lady with whom the speaker is in love with. That is the one metaphorical meaning of a butterfly. Butterfly may be a woman who is wandering around searching something whom he has to make a show or home. Show stands for the heart of the speaker. The butterfly may be a woman. It is wandering around searching for something or somebody. That is why the speaker asks the butterfly to make his heart her home. He requests her to make his heart her home. That shows the love between these two. He expects the butterfly, which stands for a lady, to love him and make his heart her home. That is the second metaphorical meaning of this poem. In the third metaphorical meaning, butterfly stands for the summer season and wind stands for the time. Butterfly stands for the summer season and the wind stands for the time. As the butterfly dissolves in the distance, so does the summer. Butterfly left the garden and it disappeared or dissolved in the air. Similarly, summer season comes and it disappears in the distance. So does the summer. The wind is too strong for a weak butterfly. The wind is very, very strong for the weak butterfly to try and fly against the current of the wind. That shows the time. The tiny fragile butterfly has an image of the young person who is about to start a new life of an adult soul. Yet another metaphorical level of this poem. Butterfly is a tiny fragile, tiny creature. It is an image of an young person. It stands for an young person, young man, who is about to start his new life of an adult soul. We have to take butterfly as an young man who is about to start his new life. Its journey is the beginning of a new life of an young man. The line in the poem supports it. Will you go from my war warm home? Even though my home, parental home, is very, very warm. Do you want to stay apart from the parental home? Start your life afresh on your own? So, this butterfly seems to be an young man who is about to start his new life in a different place. That is another metaphorical level of this poem. And butterfly's travel can be the travel of the poet all over the world, and he did not stay back. This butterfly also stands for the poet D.H. Lawrence. In the first session, we came to know the biographical details of D.H. Lawrence. He moved to so many countries in the world. He did not stay back at one particular place. So the butterfly stands for the poet himself. It shows his travel all over the world, across the world. So the butterfly's journey can be the narrator's journey into his soul. Another metaphorical meaning of this poem is that the butterfly's journey can be the narrator's journey into his own soul or self-realization. Self-realization, self-understanding, introspection. So the title shows the relationship between the speaker and the butterfly is evident. He talks to it and asks to stay with him, but it flies away. However, comfortable the garden is. Butterfly, the title butterfly, flies. It never stays, even though the poet or the speaker requested the butterfly to stay back in his comfortable garden. It cannot stay back because its name itself is fly. It keeps flying. And procreative, and the speaker is. Even though the speaker is very, very protective, even though the garden is very, very comfortable, the butterfly does not stay back in the garden. It is a bird of free will, like the poet. The poet D.H. Lawrence is also just like this bird. He is a man of free will. He went wherever he wanted to go. And he is a man who expressed his inside out. Yes. Let us try to revise whatever we learnt in this particular poem. The poem talks about the butterfly's travel from the snow-capped hill to the stormy sea. It also talks about the beauty of the butterfly. The poet uses so many terms to describe the butterfly. Its travel are parallel to the poet's travel all over the world. The travel of the butterfly is a parallel to the poet's travel across the world. The contrast between the outside world and the inside world is very well presented in this poem. The outside world is very, very stormy, and the inside world, our garden, is very, very comfortable, cozy and warm. So these are the things, and the poem has so many metaphorical meanings. We learnt all these things in this poem. Let us assess our understanding of this poem by answering some of the questions here. The month mentioned in the poem is October, November, December, September. Yes, the month mentioned in the poem is October. The butterfly rested in the poet's garden, on the speaker's shoe, on the flower, on the tree. The butterfly rested on the speaker's shoe. The image that stands for warmness is wind, sea, snow hill, garden. Garden is the image that stands for warmness in the poem. The speaker asked the butterfly, fly up the hill, fly up to the rainbow, fly down to the sea, stay in the garden. Speaker appealed to the butterfly to stay in the garden. In the poem, the speaker addresses the strong wind, the garden, sea, butterfly. Yes. The speaker in the poem addresses the butterfly. And these are the books and websites that I consulted for preparation of this presentation. Thank you for listening.